Hivyo, welcome to Rim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Business Studies Form 2, Lesson Number 21. The topic it is communication. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at our lesson objectives. We are going to discuss the barriers to the effective communication. After looking at the different or ways of choosing the right method of communication, there are the barriers to the effective communication. These are too dangerous when it comes to the communication. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to identify barriers to the effective communication. When we talk about the barriers to the effective communication, one of them it is the language barrier. This is the point where now you get that the receiver of the message and the sender of the message, they don't tarry when it comes to the language they are communicating. One is using the mother tongue, then the other one is using their foreign language. So you happen to get that the person who is receiving the information does not get to understand about the foreign language. So you require an interpreter for you to get an effective means of communication. So language barrier is one of the factors that limit the effectiveness of communication. Number two, it is the negative attitude. How does it arise? When we are passing information from one person to another, and you happen to get that the receiver has a negative attitude towards the sender, then it means that he won't record the information. He or she is not going to decode the information. Just because he has that negative attitude, he does not want to see him. He is looking down at him. So you happen to have no communication that takes place. Number two, it is the poor timing. At what time am I passing the message? Maybe I've decided to use the audio visual. At what time am I passing that information? Maybe I've decided to use the radio, the TV programs. At what time is my message being read? So if at all I do the poor timing, then it means that it won't be received to the right person I intended them to receive. Number four, it is the wrong medium. When you happen to use a fax, you send a text, and then the receiver does not have those gadgets, those medium, then it means that he's not going to receive the message. So when choosing the right method, you should also look at the medium that you are going to use. Choose it appropriately. Then the next one, it is the prejudgment. Now, when we talk about the prejudgment, it is the point where now we start giving judgment even before receiving the message. You have already created an answer. You have already known what the person is coming to tell you. Even if you thought about good news, he had good news, and you had put in your mind that whatever you are coming to receive, it is bad news. You are going to receive the bad news and receive the good news. Now, when we talk about the barriers to the effective communication, it is summarized there. We have time, language barrier. We also have noise. In case there is noise between me and you who is receiving the message, or when I was recording this video, it means that you are not going to hear what I'm saying. You're just going to have the noise as a barrier to the effective communication. Then we have the distraction. While passing information, my passing of the information, it might be distracted, put downs. You might get the put downs, something to block you as you are relaying the information. Then lack of interest, disability. discomfort with the topic, distance, too many questions, other people, and also time. Then we have the poor reasoning. We have people who never reason. They just grasp the first sentence. And after that, they come to the conclusion without waiting for them to get to the last minutes. Number five, emotional response. If at all you have received the message, you decode it, but while decoding the message, you start applying emotional feelings. So that one hinders you from receiving what you are supposed to receive and also giving back the feedback. Then, unclear systems with the organizations. This is a point where there is no order. In which system are they passing the information? Today it is from the horizontal, next it is vertical. So they don't have any system that they use when it comes to the relaying of information. Number seven, it is noise. Then unfamiliar non-verbal signs. For example, when I start using the non-verbal signs for the deaf, those people who listen to the audio, they might fail to get the information since they don't understand the non-verbal signs. They are unfamiliar. Activity. Explain four barriers to the effective communication. Reference. You can refer from the KLB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 2, that edition. If at all you want to get us, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube, from the Facebook, and you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to Edim TV. Thank you.